Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. A bombshell article just came out highlighting even more of the toxicities of cortisone injections. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to review that article here, as well as go over a prior article looking at why you need to start reconsidering getting cortisone injections. So this practice-changing article is titled Rapidly Destructive Hip Disease Following Intra-Articular Corticosteroid Injection of the Hip, and this was published in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery just a few weeks ago. So the purpose of this study was to evaluate for an association between corticosteroid injection and rapidly destructive hip disease, and the authors did a case-control analysis, and they found that hip cortisone injection was in fact associated with the development of rapidly destructive hip disease. They found that there was a dose-response curve, meaning the higher dose of steroids patients got, the higher the risk of developing rapidly destructive hip disease. And they found the same thing with the number of injections received, with more injections resulting in more hip disease. And so patients were diagnosed on average at 5 months following a cortisone injection and were characterized by rapidly progressive joint space narrowing, osteolysis, and complete collapse of the femoral head. And so the authors concluded that while the risk of rapidly destructive hip disease following a single low-dose injection is low, the risk is higher following high-dose injection as well as receiving multiple injections. And so they suggest that patients need to be counseled. They need to be counseled about the risks associated with cortisone, and that caution should be taken with hip injections using high dose as well as multiple injections. So this new study actually supports what we already found out about cortisone injections in knee osteoarthritis. And so this study was published in the Journal of American Medical Association in 2017, and it's titled Effect of Intra-Articular Triamcinolone versus Saline on Knee Cartilage Volume and Pain in Patients with Knee Osteoarthritis. The study was a 2-year randomized placebo-controlled double-blind trial studying the effects of cortisone injections versus placebo injections in patients with symptomatic knee osteoarthritis. And so over the 2-year follow-up period, they actually found that intra-articular steroid injections resulted in significantly greater cartilage volume loss than compared to saline or compared to placebo, but they found that there was no significant difference in pain. Moreover, they found that the steroid injection group also had a small increase in hemoglobin A1C levels. And so for those suffering from diabetes or having a really hard time controlling their blood sugars, even a small increase in hemoglobin A1C levels can be completely demoralizing. The authors go on to conclude, among patients with symptomatic knee osteoarthritis, 2 years of cortisone injections compared with placebo injections resulted in significantly greater cartilage volume loss and no significant difference in knee pain. They go on to say that these findings do not support the use of cortisone injections for patients with symptomatic knee osteoarthritis. So what can we take away from these two studies? Well, more and more clinical trials are coming out showing the toxicities of steroid injections, and they can have potentially catastrophic effects. Cortisone injections into joints can thin out and decrease your cartilage volume, and it can lead to rapidly destructive joint disease. We as doctors are trained first to do no harm, but with cortisone injections, we are trading very short-term pain relief, very short-term decrease in symptoms for potentially long-term damage. Cortisone injections accelerate joint disease and potentially necessitate a joint replacement. And this is why I am so excited about orthobiologics such as platelet-rich plasma. Instead of being catabolic, PRP is anabolic. It helps alter and improve the chemistry of the tissue. It uses your own cells. It uses your own body's capacity to control pain, to control inflammation, to promote tissue healing and tissue remodeling. And that's why all of the most recent clinical trials that are coming out comparing PRP injections to cortisone injections show a clear-cut winner. Hands down, the people that get PRP injections do far better in the long run. Thanks for watching. You can find me on Twitter at JeffreyPengMD, as well as on my website at JeffreyPengMD.com. See you next time.